Well, to sports now, and powerlifting, a popular sport with Pacific people requiring huge strength.
Now, John Pulu met a young Tongan in Palmerston North who has big dreams, but he's not your typical big guy.
Tui Halatokoua enjoys a challenge.
It's a satisfaction of being able to push my limits as a person.
He weighs 76 kilograms and he's lifting well above his weight.
I want to, you know, take powerlifting out of the, you know, you need to be huge to lift huge weights sort of category.
The 29-year-old school teacher got into the sport 3 years ago and already he's making a name for himself.
I'm just trying to get the look like people.
I love the fact that I can inspire other people who, you know, want to get into lifting and they're worried that, you know, the weights are going to be too heavy or they're not working hard enough. That, you know, powerlifting is a sport where, you know, you can get as low as reps of three.
And this is how it works. Depending on your age, gender and weight, you compete in three categories: squat, bench press and deadlift.
Just ask my mum and my wife, you know, I've only started to get them on my side in regards to support for what I do. My mum, just because she knows how risky it is and she knows the potential to get injured and things like that.
The father of three has raised the bar high, winning a couple of awards in some of the regional competitions. When he's not working out, he's teaching and mentoring at the local youth justice residence.
So what we're going to be looking at today, guys, is what it takes to be healthy. A lot of these young people have come from pretty hard backgrounds, whether they haven't done really well at school or the support structures at home haven't been the best. So what we try and do here is give them opportunities they may not have been exposed to.
We can't show their faces, but some of these residents are as young as 14 years old. It's Tui's goal to turn their lives around.
A few of our boys have, you know, gone on to tertiary education, which is something that, you know, we as a staff absolutely stoked to hear. Others have just gotten out and, you know, they're doing really well in their jobs and moving up in their jobs and things like that. And, you know, to be a part of that journey for them is just absolutely amazing in a teacher's eyes.
And the good news continues to roll out. Tui is qualified to represent New Zealand at the Commonwealth Championships in Canada later this year. He's training 6 days a week, but the hardest part is actually getting there.
When it comes to travelling overseas and things like that, a lot of my support comes from people that I know and people who have seen what I do and wanting to support.
He needs to raise $5,000 and his motivation is his young family.
A little bit of pride in trying to leave a legacy for my three young boys, you know, that dad's done something and represented New Zealand and you know, took something that he really enjoys and he's, you know, getting some recognition for it.
And it's a passion that's helping him continually raise the bar.
Oh, all the best to you, man. I'm going to try and raise the bar too. I can't lift though.
So what are you going to do?
Just watch other people lift. That's the end of our show for today. Catch any of our stories again on YouTube, Facebook or TVNZ On Demand.
And the petition we were talking about earlier to take action against child poverty, here's the link below. Don't forget, Tom, I'm especially saying this for you, it's Mother's Day on Sunday. Not too late to organise till 9.
Yeah, no, that's right, yeah.
You know, you just had twins.
I just had twins, so I think I owe my wife a lot. But yeah, happy Mother's Day to everyone and have a great weekend, especially to all our mothers.
Till 5:34.
People of the South, to our new homebound, Tagata Pasifika, born a people proud.